Hey guys, Marcus Katkin back with another daily fantasy update. This time to give you some waiver wire pickups for this week. Now, I do my waiver wires a little bit differently than most websites or most analysts out there. I hate the cookie cutter, like giving you the obvious guys that you need to go and pick up. So I like to give you some of those deeper guys that you should look for the future, not necessarily for next week, but long term. And we're starting off with a guy that I actually mentioned 2 weeks ago in one of these videos, and that's Lorenzo Taliaferro. Hopefully you listened to me 2 weeks ago and you picked him up for cheap with a fab budget like I did for a dollar. Picked him up, you know, and been holding on to him all this time because, personally, after the way he looked this weekend, I think even when Bernard Pierce comes back, he's going to be the starter. You know, maybe not, like I said, this week. Pierce looks like he's going to be the starter this week, but I think one more week of Pierce kind of falling on his ass and not really performing like he has all last year and the first part of this year, we're going to see a lot more Taliaferro moving forward like we saw last weekend. Next up, we got Jordan Matthews. Now, obviously, it was his coming out party, and a lot of people will probably be on the Jordan Matthews bandwagon because of those two touchdowns. But more importantly than that was his targets, his receptions, and the fact that Riley Cooper has been steadily declining this year and not looking very good. I think it's sooner rather than later that Jordan Matthews takes over for Riley Cooper in that number two role in the Eagles offense for wide receivers and probably ends up being the third receiving target after Zach Ertz, but still a very viable fantasy option. Next up, a guy that I mentioned on Sunday, Owen Daniels. Dennis Pitta is out for the season. Owen Daniels is going to pick up where Pitta left off and was already one of their primary red zone targets this season. Last season, I actually did some analysis on this. Ray Rice was their primary red zone target all last year. But with no Ray Rice, you got to find a new guy in that red zone. And it seems to be Owen Daniels. So, like I said, I can see Owen Daniels as a high-end tight end 2, low-end tight end 1. Picking up where Pitta left off and getting a lot of those red zone targets that we've already seen this year from Daniels. Next up, we got a pair of rookie quarterbacks, Blake Bortles, Teddy Bridgewater. Now, out of the two, I like Blake Bortles the best for the long term. I think he's got some good young receiving weapons out there, and I think they're going to be behind in a lot of games, so it's going to cause him to throw the ball a ton and have a lot of garbage time points. Similar to what we saw this past weekend against the Colts, putting up two touchdowns and over 200 yards in the second half. Now, that's not to say that Bridgewater isn't going to be playing from behind himself. He is. He just looked so much worse this past weekend. Had a lot of check down passes to running backs and his tight ends. Just did not look good, missing a lot of those screen passes to his running backs. And now with Kyle Rudolph out, just going to be a lot harder for him. He's going to have to start throwing the ball downfield, and I don't quite think he's ready for that. So Bridgewater, a guy that I want to watch for in the future, not necessarily picking up right now, but he's on my radar. Blake Bortles, a guy that I think you should pick up right now. Thanks again for watching, guys. Don't forget to subscribe below for my daily fantasy updates and follow me on Twitter @MarcusKatkin.